Hello everyone! In today's tutorial, I walk you through how to create in Dynamics 65 a global choice field, also previously known as a global option set. Choice field defines a set of options which contain label and value. On form, it looks like drop-down list control. It's used very often. And what if we need to have the same set of options on different tables? What if we need to synchronize values for similar choice fields across the entire environment? Today, we look at how a global choice field can address this and many other scenarios. Before we jump in, ensure you are working with any Microsoft product that utilizes Dataverse and have either System Administrator or System Customizer role. Alright, let's get started. I'll first guide you through the process in the new interface and then in the old one. In the new interface, open makepowerapps.com and select appropriate environment. Optionally, open the solution where you are making changes. Navigate to All Components. Click on New, More, Choice. Here, add the field's name and the choice options you require. Remember to save your changes. Now, whenever you are creating a new choice field on any table, you have the ability to sync it with a global choice. Ensure that Sync Global Choice option is set to Yes. Additionally, you can create a new global choice field during the creation of choice field on any table by clicking a new choice. In the old interface, you can do these actions by the next way. Open Advanced Settings. Proceed to Customizations or to the related solution. Navigate to the Option Set section. Add the field's name, input the necessary choice options, and then click Save and Close. Then, during choice field's creation via old interface, you have possibility to turn on Use Existing Option Set, and then to select appropriate global choice. Don't forget to publish your newly created global choice field. Once done, it's ready to use. Now, you have a fully functional global option set field, ready to simplify and unify your choice fields. This will save your time, reduce errors, and improve the overall structure of your Dynamics 365 environment. Thank you for joining. I will see you in the next tutorial. If you enjoyed the video, please give us a like. Don't forget to subscribe to stay tuned. We would love to hear your experience in the comments. Additionally, you can find a lot of exciting information on our blog. If you have any questions, feel free to contact our consultants. We are always here to help.